The Akkadians are part of the lineage of the Semitic, who inhabited the region of northern Syria. The Akkadians arrived in Mesopotamia around 2550 BC. They were probably looking for fertile land to settle. Right at the beginning of their expansion, the Akkadians and Sumerians had some quarrels, followed by a period of peace, which was very fruitful for the Akkadians. They kept their trade alive and an exchange of cultural linguistic relations with the Sumerians, adopting and adapting the style of cuneiform writing. But, unlike the Sumerians, who valued the development of the arts and sciences, the Akkadians were bellicose people and held war in great esteem. The Akkadians were also polytheistic. As time passed, their gods mixed with the Sumerian deities. A good example is the goddess of fertilization Ishtar, who for the Akkadians originated from the goddess Nammu, who was the goddess of the seas for the Sumerians. The Akkadians then regarded their kings as deities, or referred to them as envoys of the gods to command their subjects on Earth. The Akkadian kings also held the title of supreme priests. The coexistence between Akkadians and Sumerians had reached a point of harmony. Nevertheless, the Sumerians controlled much of the region's trade, which prevented the development of the Akkadian cities. The Sumerians were always surrounded by enemies. There were the enemy kingdoms of the Elamites and the Hurrian, and many other nomadic tribes that kept invading Sumerian lands. Also, the Sumerians had internal wars, with one city-state trying to defeat the other. Then, around 2375 BC, the Sumerian king, Lugalzagesi, unified all Sumerian cities after several battles. Lugalzagesi ruled the Sumerians for about 30 years. During this period, the Sumerians and Akkadians already lived almost as one people, having several members of the nobility of both peoples sharing positions in society. Suddenly, in the Sumerian city of Kish, Sargon emerged, who later became known as Sargon the Great. The origin of Sargon is not clear. The text written in clay at the time is incomplete, and it's also not clear how he managed to ascend to the throne. On the clay plate, the following was written: "In Akkadian, Sargon, whose father was a gardener, the cupbearer of Ur-Zababa, became king, the king of Akkadian, who built Akkad. He ruled for 56 years. After taking power over the city of Kish, Sargon declared war against the Sumerian king Lugalzagesi and attacked the city of Uruk, which was conquered after a fierce battle. Lugalzagesi was captured during the battle, and Sargon, as a sign of his superiority and disdain for the enemies, he put a collar around the neck of the defeated king and dragged him to the gates of his city. After that major victory, Sargon and his army kept conquering the other Sumerian cities and territories of the Elamites and Hurrians, creating the first empire in history, the first Mesopotamian Empire. Sargon's fame was so vast that he started to be called Sovereign of the Four Corners of the Earth, and his empire spread from Syria to the Persian Gulf, and even reached the Mediterranean Sea. Sargon was so powerful and influential that he's even mentioned in Babylonian texts. Exalting his deeds, the Babylonians wrote, "Sargon had no rival, no equal. His splendor spread upon the lands." At the same time of Sargon's grandiose achievements, war was a frequent reality for the peoples of Mesopotamia, which generated efforts to improve the military equipment used by the Akkadian soldiers. The Akkadians worshipped lions, had sculptures and paintings of these animals in their temples and palaces, and some records refer that these animals were captured to be used in battles. Sargon died around 2215 BC, at about 85 years of age, a very impressive age for the time. Soon after his death, many uprisings took place throughout the empire, and Sargon's offspring failed to maintain power for long. Little by little, the Akkadians were subjugated by the Goths, a tribe of nomads from the Zagros Mountains at the top of the Tigris River. After two centuries of existence, the first great empire in history collapsed. Sargon the Great was a powerful figure and inspired the kings of the Middle East for many generations to come.